G'day viewers. Today we're in the National Train Museum in Port Adelaide. Going to have a bit of a look around, see what we can find. Have a look at the tea and sugar train. This end of it's a bank branch. The Commonwealth Savings Bank, now known as Combank. Australia, the politically correct. Bank's going to show you a good time, apparently. Next, we appear to have a butcher. And meat and dairy. Where the butchers lived, I guess. Can't have a look in the break room. Skip the provision van because it's full of children. And brick.
The building of a railway from the south to link Port Augusta and Darwin had long been referred to in the South Australian Parliament with such names as Port Augusta to Port Darwin Railway and the Great Northern Railway. By the time of Federation, it had been discussed as part of the Commonwealth's role in building railways, but it wasn't until 1911 when the Commonwealth took over the administration of the Northern Territory from South Australia, that an agreement came into force, which said that the Commonwealth would complete the railway from Port Augusta to Darwin. The Port Augusta line was extended northwards from Oonagatta to Stewart in 1929. Stewart was renamed Alice Springs.
Fire!
But you can't actually get into any of these exhibits to have a bit of a closer look. But there's plenty of stuff here. We are, of course, heading off to the Flock Pavilion. Say that very carefully. The Flock Pavilion. Australian National Brill Railcar. ...700-class steamer on this side. ...500-class that we rode the other day on the Cockle Railroad, or Cockle Railway. And 800-class behind it. Ballast hopper. Remarkably like a tamping machine, sitting on top of a flat car. Looks like a pretty heavyweight flat car, that one. A couple of bogies sitting on another flat car. Speeder of some kind. This is the beast that replaced the Red Hen. These have come out of Revenue Service now and are museum pieces in their own right. Alright, as I was saying, now that my exposure's better, these things up in the wagon here are the forerunner to the shipping container of today. They revolutionised transit when they first came in. They don't look much like a shipping container, but that's exactly what they are, sitting in this wagon, or gondola car, whatever you want to call it, depending on where you come from on the planet. Little crane. That's what we need. Beer. And coming up here, we have a 930 class diesel. Big bastard. Ah, no steering wheel. It's a little bit cooler than my trolley. Little explosives van. You can get up and look in the windows of most of these. But unfortunately, you can't climb on most of the exhibits. That's a 500 class, which is a big, meaty unit. pulled the overland. It's a mountain type loco from the USA. It's just meaty. In case you know we are.
Second class?
Pretty posh for second class. Look at the lights. How awesome are they? Cool. Little inspection machine. This will be found on track patrol. Now apparently we're going to the Ron Fluck Pavilion. You want to say that kind of carefully. Ooh. Barefoots. Big. Riveted pressure vessels. Made in Victoria. Thompson. Cool cab. Little four-wheel wagons. Tank wagon, that's 700 class. Wish I could get further away. So this was Australia's Silverton Tramway. That's distinct from the Colorado Silverton Tramway, which is a different thing altogether. Baggage car. The steeple cab. An English one. Vickers with a pantograph. The original Indian Pacific and a 25. It's pretty similar to a W, the 25. This is the HF Jerry Walsh. Ah, that's a lot of controls. He's a complex beastie. Probably a few of these still in service. BBC didn't always mean what you think it means. So just slightly American, this one, because it's got a dinger. BHP. Looks kind of Baldwin to me. Let's go back and check the plate. Am I right? Or did I just make a dick of myself? It's a Baldwin. Another individual compartment sleeper. First class. Must be first class because the door's shut. We'll never be able to answer the question, which way round does the railway dunny paper go?